until they die in some extreme cases. So yeah, so they have the emotions, they can feel sadness and sorrow when they get killed, especially by the people who raised them. And my second argument is dogs are useful to humans. So they can get different stuff around the house and help do the housework. If they're really smart, and they can help take care of the children and other animals in the house. They can also understand human commands, which enables them to track criminals and prey, and they can also call them sledges. Do you know what sledge? Sledge is something you use as a transportation in the snow. So there are dogs that pull the sledge so you can move forward, right? And they are like children, only they can talk. That's what I think. And my third argument is dogs are loyal to human, and it's immoral to kill loyal followers when you have many other substitutions. So if someone is loyal to you, they're like your friend. You don't kill your friend and eat them. Yeah. And you have other substitutions, like you have chicken, pigs, and fishes. They are less intelligent. They don't experience that much pain when they are killed or same thing happen on them. So it's immoral to kill dogs and not the animals. That's all of my three arguments, and I have examples and metaphors to support them. Okay. So that's what you're gonna do. You have 5 to 10 minutes to prepare your speech, and I'll give you, you can take notes on these cards, but only on these cards, so you can't write too much. You're not going to write a whole script when you are talking. And feel free to use some expressions to express your opinion, like what we learned before. Would you rather, I would prefer to do, I don't mind, in my opinion, I have to say it's nice. Thank you.
we can say people should live differently. So why I think so is because if you take some information about the intensive breeding of animals, you can see that it is very hard.
Say no, I'm going to ask you what she said and what's her argument after her speech.
Okay. So intensive breeding of animals make a lot of problems to the to our planet. I can say three in particular. Is responsible of the destruction of forest, for the deforestation of the big forest in our world, because the owner have to give food to animals, and so they need ground, they need a piece of ground, mm-hmm. Yes, and every day these people destroy a lot of forest, and this is a very, very dangerous for our planet. Our things is the intensive breeding of animals are very cruel.
Cruel.
Mm-hmm. For example, if you see the breeding of cows,
cows.
When the cows burn, okay, in particular, mm-hmm. the male cows are killed as soon as they burn. Just they burn and after they kill. And this is I think is horrible because the maternity that the humanity feel for the baby comes from the animal. It's completely instinctive. Comes from the kingdom of animals. So the cow, the cows have the same feeling for the baby, and is very cruel. Also, the female of cows, they cannot drink the milk from the mom. Okay, they take it when they burn, as soon as they burn, they are bringing sono presi, I don't know in English, sorry, mm-hmm. and take away, and after, and some of them become cow for meat, and our meat. And I think that maternity is a principle in our world, and we have to protect. So we can eat meat, but we have to breed the animals in a good way and respect the maternity. And the last thing is that the major producer of carbon dioxide, CO2, is the intensive
carbon dioxide.
Thank you. Is intensive breeding of animals because they need to go to, and no, this is true. And they are. I think is the 30 or 40% of the CO2 is produced from. Intensive breeding of animals. And this caused very dangerous things for the survival of planet and humanity too, because it caused the greenhouse effect. And this is caused the climate change. And this is caused a natural disaster like tsunami, earthquakes, floods. And we can see nowadays, in all the part of the world, a lot of natural disaster, more and more than ever. And my husband worked with UN, in a natural disaster. And they say just 1 month ago that we have only 12 years to save our planet. After 12 years, if we don't do nothing to change, we destroy our planet. And this is the argument of all the government in the world. But we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And the last thing that I want to say to you is that there is a very interesting there is a very interesting movie in YouTube. The name is Cowspiration.
Yes, the documentary that
speaks that is interesting because it made from Leonardo DiCaprio.
Mm-hmm.
And one man go to speak to the association like Greenpeace and ask why you don't say to the people that they have to eat less meat, because here with that we can save our planet very fast. And they say because if we say they cannot understand about the CO2, what do you think they say? That if we say to them that they shouldn't eat meat, this is very difficult for the people to accept. And the last thing is in this documentary, you can see for one hamburger you use 1,500 liters of water for one hamburger. So I think it's very important to know and change our life gradually. Not in one way, but if I eat meat for every day, maybe I'm starting to eat only one day less. And day by day. So thank you very much.
Do you have any
going to the zoo in their childhood. My son as well likes zoos, but I try avoid to take him there. Because I think people like the experience in to see lions or tigers come out of the caves, right? Or touching the glass or to see monkeys or another animals. But I think nobody knows, I think the most of the people doesn't know before, behind this experience had many problems in the zoos. My first argument, that's it, is the cost of the capture.
Capital.
Yes.
Capital.
Yeah. When one person take the animal to bring to the zoo. Yeah.
Do you mean the capture?
Capture. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Capture when you take it out, when one people take the animals from the natural habitat.
Yes.
From the zoo. And I have to say the animals die. I read in many articles when they are separate from their families, these animals die because when they are separate from their families, they become sad and stop to eating, and the most of them die. Talk about the maternity. The babies separate from their mums. And the second argument is the animals in the zoo live in unnatural habitats. Yes. And in my opinion, zoos provide unnatural habitats because they are an appropriate natural environment for the animals. So the zoos, they are prevent, take away from the basic and natural needs of the animals. They can't run in the natural space. They can't hunting in the natural space. And
hunt.
And I think the zoos is a natural place for the animals. For example,
sorry, but your time is limited.
Really? Just one example. In New York, in the Central Park, they have one mini zoo. And in the summer, it's really sad to see the penguins in the pool. And I can see, probably many people can see, how the penguins are suffering with the hot weather, and this is a natural space for them. And the third argument, animals often die prematurely in the zoo, because I think the people, the zoo doesn't have ability for to take care of the animals, because they live in the cage, they have bad conditions, and they live in the inappropriate eating. And I think they don't have proper training for to care of the animals. And because this, I really don't like. I don't like the zoo.
Thank you.
Thank you.
But he doesn't understand, he is just 6, but I think when he's growing up a little more, he will understand.
So do you have any models?
I think, what kill the debate. So in the world, only the animals in the most similar of the people. So so we must use the animals to do the experiment to test how the medicine affect the human. So when a new the second my second point, because we the scientist researching and development the medicine to defeat the disease, they need to do a lot of experiment. We must use animals. After we sure it's not the better effect for animals, then we can use to human. So we can, if we don't use animals, should we use the human to do experiment? Because not another natural things can impede the animals to do the experiment. So even we know this, not if human do this experiment with animals is a very violent or cruel, but we must do that. So I think to be honest, I think if we so if we have no new products for the of the medicine to resist the disease, human will extinct. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So even though we know, especially for doctors, we know do this experiment for the animals is not not fair, but we must be able to do like this because for the
choose one rebuttals from the three, I have three for each, and write